Hey guys, so here we are, Jacob, Sophie, everyone say hi. And we're gonna show you guys how to make a value scale. Yeah, welcome to the Copera 2. Here we go.
What we're gonna do is we are going to first make our value scale lines on this paper, that it happens to be 11 inches long, but do you care? No. Because I don't want you to worry about measuring, okay? I also don't want you to worry about straight lines, but I know you guys are crazy about straight lines, so we'll do straight lines. Okay, so you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns.
Get me close.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns. Am I gonna worry about it being perfect?
No.
I'm just gonna have this middle column right here. Oh, look what you could do with this like cool ruler. Maybe I could just make this be one of my columns. What up? No. Okay, so that's a column. Okay, there you go. Okay, how many columns do you need?
Six. Seven.
There we go. I don't know if I'm happy with this, but depending on the width of your ruler, maybe you'll have wider columns. So you got three this way. Can you have an extra one if you want?
Yes.
Yes, but I don't want to confuse you. But you could go more. Okay, here's your middle. Okay? And, oh, look! Oh, get a zoom in there. Oh, crooked line. Am I going to freak out? No! Okay, come here. Okay? And then I need three this way, because these are going to be my shades. Okay? My husband's texting me. But I'm just going to keep going, guys, because we're doing advanced art. Okay, here we go. So, you need 10 down here. 10. Okay, so don't worry about it being perfect. 10, right? And then let's have like one column for just your titles. So we go the width of this ruler. Gosh, I hope I have a lot of these in class. Width of this ruler. Okay, these are going to be my columns, just my titles. Am I going to have enough room for 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Not, no, I won't. Okay, so they're going to have to be thinner. Okay, but here are my columns. So, main, zoom in, Rogelio, main color scheme of your painting. This is the main one, right? And then you will have here, tint three, tint two, tint one. Over here, you're gonna have your blacks, and by blacks, I mean shades. Shade three, shade. What's the next number? Two. Shade one. Should have put the one there, but I'm not going to worry. It doesn't need to be perfect. Repeat after me. It doesn't need to be perfect. It just needs to get done. Okay. Now I need 10 columns here. So I'm not going to obsess with measuring. Okay. Look, I have about 10 inches. Okay. So I'm not going to worry about it. Okay. About 10 inches left. Here we go. Oh no, watch. It's not going to be right. Do I have 10? One. Do you see how I'm getting in my head about the measurements? I don't want to do that. I am modeling, so I know I have a little less than 10 inches. So I'm going to go like here. Look how it's crooked. I'm not going to care. Oh my gosh, it's smeared. I'm not upset. I am so fearless. I'm even doing this in pen. Oh no, it's crooked. Is it going to hurt your grade? No, don't freak out. It doesn't need to be perfect. It just needs to get done. Okay? They are not perfect, like 10 inches apart. Oh my gosh, so that one goes up. What is wrong with me? It doesn't matter, okay? I am not like some crazy art teacher that's gonna give you, I just want you to start painting today. No, I'm not crazy, stop whispering about me when I'm doing the video. Okay, let's see how many I have. Okay, so see how these are different widths? It doesn't matter, okay? So this is my main color, one, okay? And this is gonna be, are you zooming in, Rogelio? Stop talking smack about me. Compliment one. So this is my main color one, compliment one. Okay, main, I'm gonna write the whole thing out, but it doesn't matter. Are you whispering about me? Main color two, compliment two. Main color three. Compliment three. Oh my gosh, I can't even read my writing. It doesn't matter. It's just for me. Okay, main color four. Okay, so I have compliment four, three more calls to fit in.
Okay, so I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna squish it a little. One here, and then one here. You could do this in pencil if you want, okay? So you have almost 10 inches down, oh, almost 11. The whole time it wasn't moving?
No, I'm joking.
What? Okay, zoom in. Okay, I can't believe it. Compliments. Four. Main. I don't even know. Color five. Compliment five. Okay. And then that's basically about it. You write your name at the top. Okay, and next we're gonna paint. But notice, see, just going in. This is gonna be your main color scheme. And then I'm gonna have you do compliments next class. We're gonna do main colors today. We're gonna do tints and shades.
Let's rock and roll. Let's go.
Film the cameraman. A lot of time is spent prepping your tray. I think you guys should share a tray, especially when we're doing a value scale this week, just so we have enough paint for the actual project. Notice how I have all of the colors and extra white. Notice how small the amount of color is that I used, because really you're only covering this area, so you don't need more paint than 50% of this. That's why you can split. That's why I'm hoping it'll work out that you split. We don't want to waste time. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to speed things up and just talk over my color mixing process.
Guys, so hi, we have a special guest here, Max. For my first main color, I did some blue purple. Notice how I'm just slightly pulling them together. Rinse your brush like crazy. Tons of white. No such thing as too much white. As soon as I started, I accidentally made a two and I just moved over. But you should start with your one, which is super hard. So tons of white. That's what I want you guys to focus on. Really, really light tints. And then I decided to do one in between that one and two. So you're always finding other colors. There's no such thing as too many tints. No such thing. What's problematic is so many of my colors were really dark. So I feel like my main colors could have almost been shades and I could have had more tints. I had to make more of my main color a lot. I think that's okay, as long as you're doing color matching. But as I was making my shades, it was really hard because the black would go down so fast. I advise you guys, instead of filling the palette like I did, that you squirt as you go. See, I'm adding on. So I really filled my palette with colors I didn't need. And as I was going, I had a sense of the colors that I needed. I'm mixing my second color now, a blue-green. Notice how dark it is. So really you want to make a ton of tints because a lot of these pure colors come out super dark. So I advise even four or five. Notice how long I'm taking mixing. Really make sure you rinse your brush well before you dive into those tints. Make sure you pull the white over and you don't let too much of the white get dirty. Here I am making my two. Making it smooth. And then I wanted to put one in between. So as I went, I was more interested in making more tints, as I said earlier. So I wish I had more boxes, because the tints are so beautiful. I needed more space for tints. But when you make tints, you're slowly adding more of the color to your mixture. That saves a lot of time. Here I am, I'm playing around with blending the colors, because they were still a little wet. And I figured, hey, maybe I make a color that I like more if I blend them together. Why not? I'm not going to trip over boxes. So here I am with my shades. As I was going, I was thinking it would be helpful to have a shade well and a tint well. Because a lot of my colors were getting dirty with the white. I was getting gray colors as I got more patient. Black brought it down super fast. and I felt like all my shades were super dark. So here I am moving on to the next color. I realized I wanted to do another cool color, so I don't know if all your main colors will be cool and all your compliments will be warm. And then OMG, I realized quickly, I did a test strip and I realized my colors were too similar. My three looked the same, and that wasn't my intention. So I added some of the complement of green, some red and orange to dull it down. And I pulled it back because I wanted a different color. So I ended up in here with more of a brown green. I even added some burnt umber. Browns are great tools. They're really, really great tools. You don't want to have all colors out of the bottle. You want to try to make new and different colors. There we go. My first tint was a number 2. Always getting dark real fast. Remember, your first tint should look almost white. So I'm mixing, I'm adjusting. That's why that space on the left and the right of the value scale are so valuable. I'm making some other colors. The camera almost fell down. Making my last tint. And those are just some really beautiful colors. So if I could tell you something, don't underestimate the power of doing a brown or adding a complement. Because colors out of the bottle can be boring. But I did 2 secondary colors, so that's blue-purple and blue-green, and now I'm doing this browny-green. None of my main colors are out of the bottle. I want you guys to experiment with making different sorts of colors, because artists experiment. Here I'm practicing just blending, because the paint was wet, and now I'm starting to add some shades. Again, as I went on, my shades got muddier and muddier, and I think that's because I accidentally got white inside of my shades. So be careful with that white. You don't want the white and the black to mix, unless it's intentional. Otherwise, you're gonna have these gray colors, unless that's what you want. Here I am, I'm making a yellow. I found that it was too bright, so I'm adding the complement now to kind of pull it back, and notice how it's turning into more of a yellow brown. So I'm having more of this mustard brown. I mixed the 2 yellows, experimented, exactly mixed. Now I have this mustard brown. So now I'm making my first tint. Here I started to use way too much paint. So I had way too much white. So again, small squirts. Less is more with this assignment, otherwise it gets real messy. Also, you don't want to fall into the trap of mixing in the canvas. I was doing that a lot. My painting teachers always told me to stop mixing on the canvas. But I feel like it's okay if you're learning, because sometimes your painting isn't mixed as well. But try to do all your mixing on the palette. So those are my tints. Notice how I'm not worried about having a hard boundary, really, between my different tints, because I'm learning. Okay, dirty, dirty shade right there. I made a mistake. I pulled the wrong color for my black. I got green on my brush. So here I'm getting tired and I'm not mixing my brush very well. Make sure you mix your brush well, guys. Otherwise, you're going to be wasting a bunch of paint. So I had to go back, remake the color, and then add some new black. So really take the time to clean. I don't know. Exactly, Max. I kind of think you all need your own palette, because look like how I'm holding it. You just don't need all the colors at once. So here, look how gray my shade is. That's because white's getting in. So, you know, you may get tired as you go on. You may make more mistakes, but that's okay. Yes, Max, but just be aware of when you're making those mistakes. Be reflective. Okay, there I have blue right out of the bottle, and I'm like, ooh, that does not look good. So I'm turning it into more of a bluer blue-purple. And now I'm adding my white. I think I tried some of the other blue. Making my tints, going, there's my number 2, there's my number 3, rinse, lather, repeat, and then making my 4. Yeah, look, 1, 2, 3, 4, I made 4 tints there. I would do 4, guys, because the tints are so gorgeous, and handscapes are a little dark. Exactly, Max. So here I am starting to make some shades. I feel like I could have even made more tints. But here I go, making my shades. It looks like I still had white on my brush. Gotta mix those brushes. I would have a shade brush and a tint brush, guys. Shade and tint brush. So things aren't getting too muddy. Paint with a lot of brushes. It got dark real fast. It got really, really dark. So I feel like I started strong and then I got weaker and weaker as I went. But that's okay. I have a variety of colors that I can work with there. There you have it. That's my color scheme, guys. But here we go. Day two. You're going to try to mix some compliments. I have news for you. Sometimes your compliments are going the opposites. Sometimes those compliments will accidentally be similar to your main colors. So I would think about that before you start to paint. When you're mixing your mid colors, you're picking your main colors. Remember, you can also make compliments too. So maybe sticking all to cools for your mains is good. Maybe pick a dominant, cools or warms as your main and then do your compliments. Because you're going to get colors that are good because you're going to have to make the opposite. I don't know if you can follow that. Ask me questions in class if you don't understand. Okay, so there you have it. So you can't really tell on tape, but the top one is, or the bottom one is more yellowy than my main brown color. That top one is brown. Okay, so as I'm adding black, it's going a little darker. Notice how I got to my last shade so fast. I was like, whoa. So I went back in. Sometimes you're bouncing around your value scale. That is okay, right, Max? It's okay. All right, here I am. I think I'm moving on to doing a compliment. Blue-green opposite would be like a red-orange, right? Don't worry, I'll project a color chart so you can use your color theory to get all up in that. Okay, my first tin, second tin, third tin. Woo! Look at how I'm getting the hang of this. Where's the music? Let's start some new music. Okay, there we go. Good job, Max. Okay, way to put that music on. Now I'm adding my black. Still got white in my brush. You seeing like where I need to work on as a painter, guys. Because no one is good at painting. I mean, if it wasn't worth doing, if it was so easy, it wouldn't be worth doing. This is hard, right? We're doing something that's worth doing. Hard, productive struggle. So here I am with my shades, rocking and rolling. You see how my palette's getting crowded. It's a good thing you guys are doing this over 2 days and I'm not being too extra. So I think you're making like 60 colors. So come early, guys, so you have time. Make your chart before class during guided study. I mean, come, I'll give you the paper. I'll cut early in the morning. Okay, there's a pause here because I was fixing Sophie's bubbles. My daughter came and was like, stop painting, fix my bubbles. So finally, let's see, I'm getting back to it. Or maybe I'm still fixing the bubbles. Don't eat that. I'm so happy you're in this video, but don't eat the light. Okay, here we go. So compliment, you know, I was stumped as to what my compliment was, because guess what? I forgot how I made that color in the middle. I forgot. So take notes as you go. Don't be like me and be like, wait, how did I make that color? So I was trying to figure out, it took me a long time to figure out what the complement of that color would be, but I ended up determining it would be like a red purple. Because I was thinking, what would be opposite the color wheel with all these colors? I didn't have my chart in front of me because I was outside. So here I go, rocking and rolling the tints. Again, I was noticing, gosh, I was like, wow, that looks really similar to my last color, right? So kind of like think about like you're always going to do the opposite, but it's a little darker. It's like more purpley. So it's good to have like a variety. Now here I am. I kind of adjusted my main color. Shh, don't tell, because I decided while I was making my tints that it should have more purple because it looks so much like the other color. So you can make changes and adjustments as you go, guys. This is like about like bending the rules, kind of figuring out what colors you want in your abstract painting. So no stress, no stress. Just keep going, keep moving forward. Right, Max? Okay, this compliment was more of a brown. I'm not really sure why, what my thinking was, but it was not going well. At this point, I was tired and I'm getting black all in my tints. Look how blacky my tints look. So like, I'm exhausted at this point. I'm not rinsing my brush. So if things are going well, take a breath. Take a deep breath. Be like, okay, you're messing up. Maybe walk around the room. Okay, here I'm doing my last one, which is more of an orange because the bottom one was out of the bottle. It's okay to have one be out of the bottle. It's fine. You know, I mean, you shouldn't, but I'm getting pretty lazy here. I got a paper blade out. But what you want to do is you really want to make sure you finish this so you have a lot of options. Then I'm putting in my main color. And then already, look how quickly it gets dark. I had way too much paint on my plate. Got dark way too much. That was way too much black. Way too much black. So there you have it. That's my value scale. In my opinion, it gets dark too fast. I would have more tints. I would have my main colors a little to the right, maybe. No,